Let's check the statistics. Maybe you noticed we didn't enter explicitly any constraint yet. That is on purpose. Don't add constraints if you didn't check the statistics. As soon as you add, delete or modify activities, you should always check the statistics. So you should do this several times before generating a timetable and one time after the, hopefully, final table was generated. Let's go through the statistics. If you are working with the activity planning, you will automatically check a lot of statistics on the fly. You can see the number of hours of the students under the students' names. So class 5D has got 28 hours. Year 5 is divided into classes and courses. The courses have got 1 to 2 hours. So students of year 5 have got between 29 to 30 hours per week. You can see the number of hours of the teachers also under their names. It is wise to enter the target hours of the teachers. Check the hide full teachers and all teachers with. The correct number of hours will disappear. So at the end the list should be empty. You can also check the number of hours per subject. You might notice bugs by checking those numbers also. There are three very similar statistics in the statistics menu. The teacher's statistics displays all names and the number of hours. You can hide the teachers with the correct number of target hours here again. In fact, this menu and the subjects menu isn't needed anymore if you work with the activity planning dialog. But the student's statistics is very useful. Uncheck the years and groups checkbox since they are difficult to understand. But check the duration of the subgroups. You remember. Students in year 5 have got 29 to 30 hours per week. A student in class 5D with course DF has got 30 hours per week. But a student in class 5D with course MP has got only 29 hours per week. Check these values carefully. If you can see wrong numbers here, then you might have added too many or too little activities. Especially if you see much too high or too low values, you probably set up a wrong student's structure. You should view and read again more about how to set up years, groups and subgroups. Since we didn't add room constraints yet, all activities will end up in unspecified room. We will care about room constraints in another video. The teacher's subjects qualification statistics should be in the best case empty. This is of course only possible if you set up the qualified subjects for teachers. There are also a few statistic matrices. You will notice that one of them is very similar to the activity planning. Maybe check the others also. Do it in the print preview or export the statistics and check them with a web browser. You should check the statistics always before adding constraints or generating a timetable. It doesn't make much sense to add constraints or generate if those statistics are incorrect. After you have generated a timetable, you should check the generated statistics before checking each timetable. Checking those statistics will be much faster. On the other hand, you should also check the individual tables later, since some bugs are not visible in the statistics and some bugs are not traceable without this. We will check these statistics with the next video and talk about how to add constraints. Don't forget that checking statistics is not torture. It is a torture to find, understand and fix unneeded bugs after hours of generating just because you were too lazy to do a quick check of the statistics. So don't forget, check the statistics every time you added, deleted or modified activities. Do that already before adding constraints. Also do it after generating. Happy timetabling!